Hey guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. Just in case you're new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Esther, and if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Kindly hit on the red subscribe button and don't forget to hit on the little bell icon. In that way, you always get notification whenever I upload a new video. So guys, today's video is all about Chacha Eke and her husband marriage crisis. I guess you guys have seen the video about Chacha Eke when she cried out saying she's done with her marriage, that she's finally living with her life. If you've watched my previous video, yeah, I did a video about that. So this is what we are going to be talking about today. So I just want to quickly say this because a lot of women are struggling in their marriage. And first thing first, marriage is meant to be enjoyed and not endured. When it make you become a shadow of yourself, just take your leave in one piece. Don't try to be like, oh, I'm enjoying this for my child, I'm enjoying this because of what people will say, I'm enjoying this because I don't want people to laugh at me and all that. If you keep saying you don't want people to laugh at you, you don't want people to know what you're going through, you don't want people to think that you are a failure because your marriage failed, my dear, you won't like the outcome. Chacha Eke, a lot of people have been saying, oh, Chacha Eke is looking sick. Chacha Eke is no longer the classic lady we used to know. And that was right, because Chacha Eke was going through a lot. Not necessarily sick, but she was passing through depression. And you know how depression will make you look. Look at when Cynthia Morgan came out from God knows where. This year, see how she was looking, because she said she was depressed, and depression can cause a lot of things. It can even make someone lost his or her life. So Chacha Eke has been going through a lot in her marriage. What is the problem in her marriage? Violence, abusive marriage. If you're in abusive marriage, you will never have rest of mind, you will never have peace, you will never have enjoyment, you will never enjoy your marriage. That is why people tell couples, if you are in any abusive relationship, lady, men, leave. Kindly leave. Divorce is not advisable. Divorce is not good. But divorce is sometimes good if that is the only option you have to save your life. Because first thing first, your life comes first before you think of any other thing. It's someone who is alive that will be thinking of what people will say. A lot of stories have been roaming about on social media saying that Chacha Eke husband impregnated her friend and all that. That is not true. That is not what happened. The real truth is that she has been inside abusive marriage for years now. They have been married for 7 years. So this is what she's been going through. That is why the Chacha Eke that was classy, the Nollywood screen goddess we all knew back then, suddenly she was looking strange. And it was so unbelievable. Someone who got married and she was looking beautiful before she was married to this man. And inside the marriage, she was looking strange with some certain behaviors, saying that she wants to stop doing makeup, she wants to stop doing this, she will have realized her mistake, that she's not supposed to be doing makeup because makeup ruin her face. And we believe that. She started going to the gym just to deceive people, to make them think, oh, she's really working out, and this is the reason why she lost a lot of weight. But she has been pretending. A lot of things are troubling our young ladies these days. When things are going bad, talk to someone. Instead of that thing to put you through depression, talk to someone. Tell someone what you are going through. Speak out. It's better for you to speak out than to die in silence. This lady, according to what some of her colleagues said then when her issue came up before, they said she's smiling and crying every night. Chacha Eke is soaking her bed with tears. She's soaking her pillow with tears, but come out in public and look good, snap picture with her husband, family pictures and all that, and try to be like, oh, the family is perfect and people are looking up to them and all that. That is why I tell people, be it me or anyone, do not try to be like me, because you don't know what me myself is going through in my house. You don't know what I'm going through. You only know the things I want you to know. You only know the things I show you. What about the ones I don't show you? You don't know what I am going through. So don't ever want to be like me. It baffled me online. You see people tapping into people's grace, tapping into people's blessings, tapping into people's marriage. Like a lot of our young ladies just on palm wine tapper from nowhere. start tapping. I want to be like you. I pray to be like you. I tap for your blessing. I tap for your miracle. I tap from your grace. What grace are you tapping from? This is a lesson to everyone because things happen for others to learn. I just pray no one learned through their own mistake, but a lot of people have learned their lesson through their own mistake. Pray to God, kneel down, for God to give you your own man, your perfect match, your soulmate, someone that will understand you, love you for the real you, love you for your mistake, correct you when it's necessary, and not turn you into a punchy bag. The people you are tapping from their grace, the people you are tapping from their miracle, you don't know what they are going through in their house. Imagine a marriage that is under pretense, a marriage that is full of pretense. You are tapping from that marriage. You are tapping from that blessing. I'm just saying this just to open people's eyes because a lot of people do this. I see this a lot in comments. People will be tapping. What are you tapping? Don't you have mouth to pray? Don't you have need to go on your knee to pray to God for God to give you what you want, what is best for you, instead of tapping from people? I don't mean admiring people is bad. You can admire them. It ends there. Anything you see on social media, admire, ends it there. Do not take it into, I want to be like this person, I want to be like that. So guys, that aside, Chacha AK, I just hope and pray God give her the wisdom to handle this issue. And what I'm thinking now is, they might not have gone their separate ways now, because if not, she will not be answering the same name that she's answering before on social media. She's still answering the man's name, Chacha AK Fine. Probably because she was rushed to the hospital, she's not with her phone right now. I don't know, but the husband's profile picture still have a picture and his picture, like they are both picture on the profile picture. So probably they've not gone their separate ways yet. They've not divorced yet, but she just cried out on social media because of the pressure she was going through the other day. Because you guys saw the video, how she made the video, it was as if something was really going on that day. So she was not herself and she just needed to voice that. If you see the video, it was unfiltered video and uncomfortable video. She just did it and she just posted it, even without caption and others. You can tell that something was going on that day. So I really pray for her, that God's strength to be with her, because I heard she's in the hospital right now because she's depressed and she's been going through a lot. So reactions and reactions upon reactions has been going on social media. People reacting to this, people saying their mind, giving their opinions and their thoughts and what they were thinking before Chacha AK finally came out with the truth. So I'll just read some for you guys and that is it. So this one really got my attention, so I'm going to be reading this. This lady said, "When I saw your pictures last year, Chacha, I wrote it that no matter what you are trying to cover up, that it will never change the fact that you are in an abusive marriage, because I know it's only an abusive marriage can make a beautiful lady like you turn that way. You kept denying that with the reason you stopped applying makeups. I am a psychologist by profession, and I know when one is battling emotionally. I thank God you have decided to take a walk, at least with your two legs alive. You don't need to explain much to the world, my dear, because whoever that has eyes would know you fought a great battle in that marriage." She's so right, because Chacha, whatever she was passing through, it was affecting her emotionally, physically. Like, we could tell all was not right with Chacha, but she kept denying it.
I was talking to a veteran colleague in the industry earlier, and he says, Oyibo standard has messed up with the mentality down here.
Western culture.
The man brings a ring, gets down on one knee, and...
Of course not.
Yeah, maybe. Some people... So why did you give me a ring? See, I didn't need that. He didn't give me a ring, all right? This dude wrote me a BBM chat. BBM. Top marker. Black belt.
What's the essence of proposing? Is it not to tell the young girl, "I love you and I want you to be mine"?
I knew you always wanted to marry me. I knew you always wanted to marry me. Asking you. All this thing you're doing for me. Are you sure you don't have, plans to marry me? So you're in my house in Lagos, chatting with my best friend
No, that one was a call. The first one was a call.
You didn't tell me on call.
No, call. The first time was a call.
It was your birthday. It was your birthday. I was looking and I was like, oh, sad I wasn't there for you. I'd have cooked sauce and rice, like, you know, shut it down. Mm-hmm. So next thing you know, he starts to get emotional. And he's like, would you consider making this man happy for the rest of your life? And I laughed so hard, like,